state elections could have major impacts. Here's what to watch for on Tuesday. Most elections taking place on Tuesday, November 7, 2017, are just small local elections, and many believe they don't really have a significant impact on the national political landscape. However, some state elections could have some major impacts, and here's what you need to watch for. New Jersey is electing a new governor. With the Democrats already holding huge majorities in both state houses of the legislature, the only race with any significant impact for New Jersey is the election of governor. Chris Christie will not be able to run for re-election due to term limits, but it will be interesting to see if the Republican Party can maintain control under the numerous scandals of Christie, or whether the Democrats will gain control of the entire state, the governor's seat and both houses. Some of Christie's scandals include using a beach he closed to the public, as well as a closure of a bridge as political retribution. Tomorrow, the citizens of New Jersey get to decide between Republican nominee Kim Godogno and Democrat Phil Murphy, and right now in the polls, Godogno is losing bigly, she's down by double figures to Murphy. However, if she's able to make it a close race during the actual election, it could be telling of a right-wing revolution in a blue-dominated state. Virginia. Tuesday will be a huge day in my home state of Virginia, as not only a new governor is being elected, but the entire House of Delegates is up for grabs. What's interesting about Virginia governor elections is that the Commonwealth has elected Republicans and Democrats in equal numbers since the 1969 election. Since that 1969 election, the score is dead even at 6-6. Current Lieutenant Governor and Democrat Ralph Northam and Republican Ed Gillespie square off tomorrow to break the tie. Early on in the campaign, Northam was way ahead in the polls, but the race has tightened, and the Democrats' new political ad proves that they're nervous. You can expect a close race when the voting happens tomorrow, especially after the nationalist right-wing movement of Corey Stewart nearly put him in the position of the GOP nominee for governor. Now with backing from both Stewart and Steve Bannon, Gillespie may go from being way down in the polls to win the election. A recent poll from Hampton University even had Gillespie up by as much as 8 points. Most polls have the race closer, and the race is most likely going to come down to two counties. When it comes to the House of Delegates, the majority of Virginia is still a conservative state, so the Republicans are expected to hold a large majority that they already had. Washington. After the death of Republican Andy Hill, Washington's state Senate District 45 seat is up for grabs in the form of a special election between Manga Dingra, D, and Jining Lee England, R. Even though it's been a Republican-held seat, you can't help but to marvel at the fact that Hillary Clinton won this district, 65-28, against Donald Trump, so the Democrats' chances of taking this state Senate seat is great. If they do so, then they'll take control of the chamber, giving them complete control of the state for the first time since 2012. Obviously, these elections don't have the firepower that the 2018 congressional elections are going to have, but these are a few key elections to pay attention to tomorrow that will have a significant impact at the local level and could also be telling of where states decide to go next year for Congress. This is going to be interesting, and fun, as elections always are.